It's Michelle here, back to share another cute and simple style with you. So watch how I take my hair from these hair banded twists, from this to this. For starters, I wore this style to my niece's baby shower. So when I posted it on social media, people said that they wanted to see me do a tutorial. So here it is. So I start out by removing the bands, obviously, and then I'm releasing these twists. These twists were initially a bunch of twists, which I then just joined into a bunch of big twists because it is soon to be wash day. So I'm removing the twists from my hair and I'm lightly detangling it. I had flat twisted the sides already and I didn't remove them. I just joined them with the twists. So here you see me just taking them apart. Then I'm going to clip my hair up into sections and start working on the front. So while I finger detangle and remove these twists and clip them into sections, I'm going to speed up the video. And as you can see here, I have very, very frizzy hair at the roots. I feel like I'm always working to tame that area. It's just shorter all over the entire top perimeter of my head. I don't think it's breakage, because I think it's actually new growth that's always just going in, and it's just always fuzzy and frizzy. But anyway, as you see here, I'm sectioning out the front, which is where I will put what I'm calling my obnoxious pompadour. Now, the reason I'm calling it obnoxious is because having fine natural hair, it's very difficult to get your hair to be big. And so I really like the results I got doing this pompadour, and so I'm calling it obnoxious for my hair. So yeah. Now that I'm all sectioned out, I'm gonna lay these edges with my favorite gel. Y'all know what it is, the Equal Styler Curl and Wave Gel. I'm just gonna lay my edges down. I have my hair sectioned and I'm going to flat twist on each side of my head to twist. I make sure they're nice and taut. I will not twist all the way to the end. I am just twisting up to the end of where my hair, I guess, stops connecting with my scalp. Now, as you can see here, I'm pinning it into place, and I like to pin my bobby pins into my flat twist so that they go in toward the bobby pin. That way I only need to use one bobby pin. So repeating it on the second section of hair, I'm going to add some gel, or I'm adding some gel, and I am flat twisting that section. Now I'm repeating it on the other side, and notice I only use my fingers to part my hair. It's very rare that I will use a comb. When I do use a comb though, I will use a rat tail comb. But for the purpose of this style, I am just using my fingers and I am bobby pinning into place the flat twists. And this is what I'm left with. Now that those twists are done, I am releasing the front of my hair and I'm going to create my, my obnoxious pompadour. And I'm gonna add a little bit of the Shea Moisture Sea Salt Texture Spray, which tends to kind of like pump it up a little bit. So after I fluffed and I gather the front section of hair, I twist it and then I pin it back. Now you can play with the placement of that pompadour so that it's either on the very top of your head or you can push it back. I think in this video here, I'm actually creating it a little further back than I like, and then I'm gonna remove it and redo it again because I didn't like the way it came out the first time. Here I go, repinning it again, giving it a little bit more lift and pinning it back a little bit further, positioning it the way I like it. And at the end of this video, you'll actually see how I wore it the very first time I did it. it was actually more obnoxious than this. It was a lot higher. Now that it's all pinned, it's time to admire your handiwork. Just fluff to your liking, position your curls the way you like it, and that is it. I'm gonna fluff a little bit more and maybe vogue for the camera some, separate my hair a little bit more, and then the pictures will follow. Thanks for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.
A prayer. A person who prays. Someone who goes right into action.